is Friday Night Live on Channel 4. We've got to go out at 7 o'clock, so we've got to get on with the show. Girls, this one's for you. On tonight's show, we got Sean Bean, Dean Sullivan and Jon Bon Jovi. And musically, we've got the Lightning Seed, Supergrass and Jon Bon Jovi with his band, Bon Jovi. Before, and today we have a big exclusive on the show. I asked them to do this song just this afternoon. This is Mr. Bon Jovi and Mr. Sambora with Mrs. Robinson.
Good news to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Oh, oh, oh. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven loves to play for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. We'd like to know a little bit about you for our vibe. We'd like to help you learn and help yourself. Look around you, all you see are sympathetic eyes. Stroll around the grounds until you feel at home. Good news to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven will be played for those who pray. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hiding in a hiding place where no one ever goes. We give you no pinch, we give you no cupcakes. It's a little secret, just the Robinsons affair. Most of all, we've got to hide it from the kids. Coo-coo-ca-choo, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa-oh-oh. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Yeah-eh-eh. Yeah-eh-eh. Sitting on a sofa on a Sunday afternoon, going to the candidates debate. Laugh about it, shout about it, and you've got to choose. Any way you look at it, you lose. Where have you gone, Joe DiMaggio? Our nation turns in a lonely eye to you. Ooh. What's that you say, Mrs. Robinson? Joe and Joe have left and gone away. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey.
Clapometer, did you see it?
Yes.
Wasn't it a beautiful sight? Well, look, you've heard him sing. Now let's hear him speak. John Bon Jovi. See, did you hear that? I said, John, welcome to the show, man.
Man?
Because you just can when you hang out with John, you see. So, John, do you have any idea at all how attractive you are? Do you?
Chris likes me.
We all like you. We want to get the biggest bed from IKEA that they do, and we all want to dive in it right there with you.
Well, all right. I'm easy.
Now, are you?
Yeah.
Now, you know, you're in Britain for many things.
Yeah.
Having a good time, hanging out. You've been here for how long?
2 months.
2 months. And tell us exactly what you've been doing over the last 2 months.
We're filming a movie called The Leading Man.
Okay. Tell us about it.
Well,
tell us how you got the part, first of all.
I begged, I pleaded, I borrowed. Yeah.
Do you think you'd have got the part if you weren't John Bon Jovi?
I don't know. Fuck.
Sorry?
Probably not.
But is it a French-English film? What's the deal here?
No, it's English. So it's English. It's a very international cast in that...
Lambert Wilson, who is one of the stars in it, is French. Anna Galena is Italian. Barry Humphries is in it. Tandy Newton is in it. They're both English.
And Tandy's here. Hello,
Tandy's here.
You saw in the clip earlier on, and you've about seen another clip now, because you've been filming in Richmond, haven't you?
We've been everywhere. You know, I'm like a guy from the National Tourist Board of England now. I've been, you know.
Do you know it all?
Oh, yeah, out there in Trafalgar Square.
Hey, John, tell us about England. Go on. John Bon Jovi's Guide to England.
Well, first of all, you have to get your own driver, because you can't find...
Oh, right.
We can work on this. John Bon Jovi's Guide to England.
Okay.
Right? You get a driver in a Range Rover. You get a guy named Freddie driving around in a Range Rover. So he's doing it. Here's Freddie right here.
Freddie's there. Listen, when we were outside the house, because I came to watch your film yesterday, Freddie was hanging around outside, because you've got blacked out windows on your Range Rover, haven't you?
Yeah.
And there were two girls who'd come to see you, two, I don't know, 12, 13, 15, I was 18.
Lie to me, tell me they were 18 or I'm going to jail.
I don't know. They were there, and they got hungry, so Freddie took them to McDonald's in your Range Rover. What a nice bloke! Freddie, heart of steel.
What else did he take in that Range Rover?
Got no idea, John, to be honest. Now, we've got an exclusive rush from the film, because the film's not out till November, is
That's
it?
That's right.
Okay, it's not out till November. But this scene, and this is a genuine scene, it wasn't like the one you saw before. This scene was shot on Tuesday, it's been processed for us. Nobody else has even seen anything of this film, and here it is. Here's a clip for you.
I just want you to know that I would have killed for this film.
I'm glad that was unnecessary.
It's true, though. I mean, those scenes with me and Rachel. She's great, Hillary, isn't she?
Mm.
And she's a real fine. You know, I mean, the tension, the suspense at the end, have I really fallen for her or not? And I get to grab that gun, it's like, bang, 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 you know? I mean, man, that's some climax.
Well.
There was more, but after that, John said it's pay-per-view after that particular sentence. So did you always want to act?
No, I had no desire to get into acting. It was after I did the Young Guns soundtrack that I had my first taste of it. Because the actors learn how to do such cool things. You know, if it's like riding horses, jumping out of airplanes, race cars, you know, there's always something cool to learn in these films. So.
Does it mean that it's the end of Bon Jovi?
No.
Not just no, but
thank
no.
No.
Well, how are you gonna balance it?
Just the idea of, you know, we're gonna do records, and when the band aren't doing records, then I'll look to do some movies.
So when's your next album, and when's your next film? Let me ask you that.
Well, this film, let's get over this film. We have a big tour lined up for the summer, as you may know. We're playing here in Milton Keynes and. But after that, you know, there's Richie's going to go off and do a solo record, and I'm going to go in the studio and do some stuff, and there's the Richie fan club. Yeah!
You know, if the band wasn't named after you and it was named after one of the other members of the band, I mean, what kind of names would we have? Sam Bora? What would we have?
I would dig that.
What are the other surnames of the musicians?
Hectico Samuel Juan Torres.
Well, you couldn't call him that, could you, really?
We'd be big in Latin America.
You'd be huge. You? And who's that? What does he do?
Tico Torres is our drummer.
Is he the drummer?
Yeah, but he's not here today.
Isn't he? Where's he?
No, so just so you guys don't worry about this. Like, it's not like Tico's not in the band or not.
Right, okay.
Tico has become this amazing artist, and he's got a huge exhibit.
He's
in
leaving
Vegas.
The band. You're all good. This is it, isn't it? He's going to be an artist. You're going to be a film star. Richie's going to busk.
We make a lot of money.
You got to stick together.
Yeah.
Next film, please.
No, I haven't decided yet. No.
But you're going to do more. Definitely going to do more.
Unless the critics just kill me in this one.
It'll be all right. It'll be all right. Hello. You know what this is for, don't you? Because apparently once what John did was...
Whatever I did, I'm sorry, Chris. I didn't know it was your wife.
He blew... hang on,
excuse me?
He saw that match for me, please, a second, will you? Apparently, he blowtorched somebody's name into some wood once. And we're going to let him do our desk again. And next
Jesus.
Week, we're going to give our desk away. So if you can...
Oh, cool.
To a Bon Jovi fan. So can you just blowtorch something into our desk? Don't try this at home, kids, please. Go on. What are you going to do for us, John? Should be lovely.
Wow.
Oh, no, it's blowing yourself. Oh, you see. This is no good, is it? We can get it going again, I suppose.
Wait a minute. I guess this is live TV, huh? Go ahead, Chrissy, baby.
Okay, no problem, Johnny boy. Is it going to work? Oh! All right, well, as John's doing that... What are you going to put on there?
I've just got time for initials. This is only an hour's show, okay. Right?
Well, you can finish it off later. Can you finish it off
later? Sure.
Put the JB there now.
All right. Trying to get that.
Oh. Well, the fact is, all right, John, hang on a minute, will you? Is he like this at home, Dorothea? This is his wife. This is Dorothea over here. Can we get a shot of Dorothea? Does he always finish things that he started, Dorothea? Yeah, he does.
Okay.
Very thorough guy. All right. John, that's enough for now.
All right.
We were going to get you to do some Hamlet, but we'll get you to that next time you come. Will you come back again and see us?
Fair enough. Yeah, man. Thank you.
Okay, John with Jovi. There he is. Thanks to all our guests, Sean Bean, Dean Sullivan, Cher, Supergrass, the Lady Cheese and the Lord of Love, and his inspiration, Lucy. We'll be back tonight at 5 to 12 with the repeat, and John will be 34 years old.
There you go.
We're going to leave him with this man on stage out there with his new single. It's These Days. Bon Jovi, goodbye. Thank you very much.
Walking around, just facing the crowd, trying to keep myself out of the rain. So this vagabond king with a styrofoam crown wondered if I might end up the same. There's a man out on the corner, been singing old songs about change, and everybody's got their cross to bear these days. She came looking for some shelter with a suitcase full of dreams to a motel room on the boulevard. She's trying to be Dave's name. She's seen all the disciples. She's seen all the wannabes. No one wants to be the thirsty place. Still there's nothing to hold on to but these days. These days are stars in my lorry. These days there ain't a ladder on the street. Oh, these days are fast, nothing less. It's a graceless age. Nobody left but us these days. Now Jimmy's shoes busted both his legs, trying to learn to fly from the second story window. Jimmy jumped and closed his eyes. His mama said he was crazy. He said, "Mama, I've gotta try. Don't you know that all my heroes died? And I guess I'd rather die than fade away. But these days are the stars in my lorry. These days bury a ladder on the street. Oh, you see my face. Midnight train. We ain't no fire.